Right, see the question number third one. Think what asset purchased before 2 years. Asset purchased before 2 years. Our accounting period started 1st April 2020 and end of the year 31st March 21. Estimate change beginning of the year. It is relevant for depreciation for the year calculation. Think if it has given estimate change, how to calculate annual depreciation. From the beginning, try to calculate annual depreciation before changes in accounting estimates. Annual depreciation equal annual depreciation cost value equal 8 million and residual value is given 1.6 million divided by useful lifetime. This is annual depreciation before changes in account estimates. Lifetime it has given 8 years. Therefore, annual depreciation equal 800,000 before changes in accounting estimates. And our accounting period started 1st April 2020. Therefore, before asset purchase before 2 years. Therefore, can be calculated accumulated depreciation. Accumulated depreciation can be calculated up to beginning of the year. It has used 2 years. Therefore, annual depreciation equal 800,000 into 2. Therefore, this is the accumulated depreciation as at 1st April 2020. But there's accumulated depreciation there as 31st March 21. Therefore, beginning of the year, estimate change, useful lifetime and residual value change. Therefore, this is the way you have to calculate annual depreciation after changes in accounting estimates. Therefore, depreciation equal cost value minus accumulated depreciation minus if it has given new residual value minus, then divided by remaining useful lifetime. Then try to calculate annual depreciation now. There's accumulated depreciation as at 31st March 21. Think estimate change beginning of the year. Therefore, now cost value equal 8 million. And accumulated depreciation up to beginning of the year equal 1.6 million. As well as new residual value also given. New residual value equal 1 million. Therefore, deduct 5 million and divided by remaining useful lifetime. It has given remaining useful lifetime also 4 years. Estimate change. This is the way you have to calculate annual depreciation after changes in accounting estimates. Take the answers. Cost minus accumulated depreciation minus new residual value divided by remaining useful lifetime. Therefore, annual depreciation equal 1,350,000. This is annual depreciation after changes in account estimates. And think about up to beginning of the accumulated depreciation equal 1.6 million. They ask carrying amount now. So they ask, what is the accumulated depreciation? Now there's accumulated depreciation as at 31st March 21. End of the year, there's accumulated depreciation. Beginning of the accumulated depreciation equal 1.6 million. And annual depreciation equal 1,350,000. then take the total value. They ask accumulated depreciation as at 31st March 21. Therefore, take here total amount equal 2,950,000. Therefore, this is the accumulated depreciation as at 31st March 2021. Therefore, answer is first one. Question number three, answer one. Think about estimate change, very important. Purchase date, think about, and beginning of the year, our accounting periods, up to beginning of the year, it has used 2 years. Then think how to calculate annual depreciation before changes in account estimates and after changes in account estimates. They ask accumulated depreciation as at 31st March 21. Next one. Question number fourth one. Relevant for second time revaluation. Those are accounting policies, revaluation model and cost model. Normal accounting policy should not be changed from time to time based on consistency concepts. But think about question number fourth one. The profit and other comprehensive income for the year end 31st March 21, it has given 4.5 million. 1.2 million profit and other comprehensive income, but given the other comprehensive income represents surplus 1.2 million resulting from revaluation of building, land and building for the second time during the current year. Think about other comprehensive income included second time revaluation surplus. Then total revaluation surplus cannot be included under other comprehensive income if there were previously loss. And given here, the revaluation of land and building for the first time on 31st March 2018 had resulted in deficit 400. Think this year surplus equal 1.2 million, but there were first time deficits. Therefore, total value cannot be included. Other comprehensive income. There's profit for the year as less total comprehensive income. Profit for the year and total comprehensive income. Think profit for the year plus other comprehensive income equal total comprehensive income. There's total comprehensive income. Think how to calculate total comprehensive income. Profit for the year plus other comprehensive income. Profit for the year plus other comprehensive income. Profit for the year plus other comprehensive income equal total comprehensive income. It has given as a profit for the year 4.5 million. It has given 4.5 million. As a profit for the year, it has given. And other comprehensive income also given 1.2 million. It has given 1.2 million. It is not correct. Total revaluation surplus should not be included under other comprehensive income. And total comprehensive income based on those information, this one plus this one equal 5.7 million. But think about this is not correct. Revaluation surplus equal 1.2 million this year, second time profit, but they have a first time loss. Therefore, amount equal for first time loss should be included under expense within brackets. When recording this year surplus, they have a first time loss. Therefore, amount equal for previous loss should be included profit and loss accounts under other expense within brackets. Therefore, effect for expense decrease, if expense decrease, effect for profit increase. Therefore, that value, effect for profit increase. Therefore, this is the correct profit equal 4.9 million. Amount equal for, when recording this year surplus, year par loss equal for manak, may par surplus again, other expense black hats will dhanu nabi. Ether expense black hats will dhanu, expense will adu vena, profit take a vena. therefore this is a correct profit. Thing and other comprehensive income total 1200 cannot be incurred. 400 should be included under expense. Balance part should be included under other comprehensive income. Therefore, 400 cannot be included. Should be deducted. Correct value be equal. This is value should be included under other comprehensive income. 400 expense. Profit equal 1.2 million. But they have a first time loss. Therefore, amount equal for previous loss should be included income statement other expense within brackets. Therefore, expense decrease. If expense decrease, profit increase. And under other comprehensive income, total 1.2 million should not be included. Only 800,000 should be included. 400,000 should not be included other comprehensive income. Therefore, there's correct value, but it is not effect for total comprehensive income. Total comprehensive income equal 5.7 million. Therefore, this is the correct answer. Second time revaluation surplus cannot be included total value under other comprehensive income. Definitely this year also they ask. Therefore, profit for the year equal 4.9 million and total comprehensive income equal 5.7 million. Sometimes there's other comprehensive income also. Therefore, here answer equal 5. Question of fourth one, answer 5. Think question number 5, relevant for warranty. Think warranty, it has given opening balance also. Sumit PLC sales product with 1 year warranty period. And given provision for warranty as at 1st April 2020 opening balance, 800,000. Warranty expense paid. And warranty expense recognized for the year in 31st March 21. Given warranty expense paid and recognized amounts, they ask, what is the provision for warranty to be recognized in the statement of financial position as at 31st March 2021? Think provision for warranty has given opening balance also. Provision for warranty has given opening balance also. Therefore, normal double entry. Warranty expense account debit, provision for warranty credit. Warranty expense account debit, provision for warranty credit. Now it has given provision for warranty opening balance also. There are two ledger accounts you have to prepare. Warranty expense accounts as well as provision for warranty. Warranty expense. And provision for warranty. Provision for warranty account opening balance, it has given 800,000. That is a liability balance brought forward credit side. Balance brought forward credit side, 800,000. And given warranty expense paid and warranty expense recognized for the year in 31st March 21. Warranty expense paid equal 500,000. Cash account credit, provision for warranty account debit, 500. As a cash. And warranty expense recognized during the account period, 1.2 million. Warranty expense account debit, provision for warranty credit, double entry. Warranty expense recognized for the year in 31st March 21, 1.2 million. Double entry, warranty expense account debit, provision for warranty account credit. Therefore, warranty expense account debit, name of other ledger account as a provision for warranty. And provision for warranty account credit as a warranty expense. Think double entry. Then they ask, what is the provision for warranty to be recognized in the statement of financial position as at 31st March 21? Closing balance, they ask provision for warranty. Therefore, now provision for warranty balance carried out. Credit side total amount equal 2000. Take that value debit side. Difference value as a balance carried out. That is a value should be included financial position, 1.5 million. And it should be included as a balance board forward credit side. Therefore, this is a value should be included financial position as a provision for warranty. Therefore, they ask, what is the provision for warranty to be recognized in the statement of financial position as at 31st March 21? Answer is 5. Therefore, question number 5, answer 5. Next one, question number 6. Relevant for ratios. Question number 5 and 6, relevant for ratio analysis. It has given use the following information. Answer the question number 6 and 7. Given sales of accounting period end of the year 31st March 21. Think about given information. Ratio is very important. It has given sales value equal to 12 million. Cost of sales equal 7 million. And given finished goods opening and closing stock. By using those information can be calculated average stock. And operating expense. And given interest expense and income tax expense. Number of ordinary share issue 5,000. And equity of the business also given 5 million. As at 31st March 21. First one, they ask inventory turnover ratio. How to calculate inventory turnover ratio? Cost of sales divided by average stock. Inventory turnover ratio equal cost of sales available 700,000 divided by average stock. Therefore, try to calculate inventory turnover ratio. Inventory turnover ratio. Cost of sales divided by average stock. Therefore, inventory turnover ratio can be calculated. Cost of sales equal 7,000 divided by average stock. Think how to calculate average stock. Average stock means opening stock plus closing stock divided by 2. This is opening and closing stock. Opening stock and closing stock. It total value divided by 2 equal average stock. Therefore, 1.2 million plus 800,000 equal 2 million divided by 2 equal 1 million. Therefore, average stock equal 1 million. Cost of sales divided by average stock. Average stock equal 1 million. Then can be calculated stock turnover ratio. Therefore, stock turnover ratio equal 7. 7 times. එකනේ අවුරුද්දක් ඇතුළත පර්චේස් කරනවා විකුණනවා පර්චේස් කරනවා විකුණනවා වගේ හත් පාරක් වෙනවා that is a mean of inventory turnover ratio cost of sales is given divided by average stock can be calculated opening stock plus closing stock divided by 2 next one there's interest cover ratio equal profit before tax plus interest divided by interest. Think what? Sales minus cost of sales, gross profit can be calculated. And gross profit minus operating expense can be calculated profit for the year also. Sales minus cost of sales, gross profit can be calculated. Sales minus cost of sales. Sales value equal to 12 million. From that value, deduct cost of sales equal 7 million. Therefore, gross profit can be calculated. Answer is a gross profit. Therefore, sales minus cost of sales gross profit equal 5 million. From that value, deduct operating expense. Deduct operating expense. Operating expense. Operating expense value equal 2,300,000. Then AS is a profit before interest and tax. මොන දැන් ඒ AS එක තමයි profit එක interest එකයි tax එකයි deduct කරන්න කලින්. Therefore this is AS profit before interest and tax. Value equal to 2,700,000. Then deduct interest expense as well as income tax expense. Profit for the year can be calculated. This is profit before interest and tax. Profit before interest and tax equal to 2.7 million. Tax ekai interest ekai deduct karana kale. That is the value we have to use to calculate interest coverage ratio. Therefore, interest coverage equal profit before interest and tax divided by interest expense. Therefore, interest expense it has given 900. Therefore, interest coverage ratio equal 3 times. Interest coverage equal 3 times, as well as inventory turnover is equal 7 times. Therefore, question number 6 answer. Question number 6 answer 4th one. Question number 6 answer 4th one. Inventory turnover ratio equal 7 times, as well as interest cover ratio equal 3 times. Think profit before interest and tax. Profit before interest and tax. Sales minus cost of sales can be calculated gross profit. Then deduct operating expense. Operating expense deduct. Therefore, this is answer profit before interest and tax. Profit before interest and tax equal 2.7 million. Then think interest cover ratio as well as inventory turnover ratio. Next one, there's return on equity ratio. Equity capital equal 5,000 and net profit can be calculated. This is profit before interest and tax. From that value deduct interest expense as well as income tax expense. Net profit also can be calculated. Therefore, deduct interest expense. Interest expense should be deduct value equal 900. As well as deduct income tax expense also. Tax expense. Tax expense. Income tax expense also given. Think how to calculate net profit. This is a profit for the year. Therefore, profit for the year equal 2.7 million from that value deduct 900 as well as 800. Therefore, profit for the year equal 1 million. Profit for the year equal 1 million. This is the net profit. There's return on equity ratio. Return on equity ratio equal profit for the year divided by equity capital. It has given equity capital also 5 million. Therefore, take the answer. Return on equity ratio can be calculated. Profit for the year 1 million divided by equity capital 5 million. As a percentage, therefore, into 100. This is a return on asset ratio. Profit for the year divided by equity capital into 100. Therefore, here answer equal 20%. Think how to calculate return on equity ratio equal 20%. And there's earning per share. Earning per share equal profit for the year divided by number of shares. Therefore, profit for the year equal 1 million divided by number of shares equal 500,000. Therefore, earning per share equal rupees 2. Earning per share equal rupees 2. Therefore, return on equity ratio equal 20%. Profit for the year, profit for the year mean profit after tax. divided by equity. It has given equity value. Therefore, question number 7 answer equal. Question number 7 answer. Return on equity ratio 20% and earning per share equal. Think earning per share equal profit for the year divided by number of shares. Think how to calculate net profit, profit for the year. Profit for the year mean profit after tax. And think how to calculate profit before interest and tax. It is relevant for interest cover ratio calculation. Profit එක අපි ගන්නෙ interest එකයි tax එකයි අඩු කරන්න කලින්. For calculate interest cover ratio. Therefore question number 3rd one, question number 7 answer 3. Very important ratio analysis also. Think what there are two question relevant for ratio analysis. Next one, question number 8. Question number 8. Relevant for accounting equation and given total assets and total liability of the entity for the year end 31st March 2021, it has given. And following errors had been found after arriving at above figure. Thus, what is the amount of total asset and total liability respectively after making correction of above errors? At first one, write the accounting equation. And first one, take the given balances. Error correction with accounting equation. Assets equal liability plus equity. First one, write the accounting equation. Then record given information. Assets equal liability plus equity. And given total asset equal 1 million. Total asset equal 1 million and liability value it has given 300,000. It means equity can be calculated. Equity equals 700,000. It has not given but can be calculated. This is the equation. Then think about errors. That's what is the amount of total asset and liability after correcting above errors. After correcting above errors. Think first one, an advance of 20,000 received from customer to sales goods in April 2021 has been recognized as revenue. Think about our accounting period end of the year 31st March 2021, but advance received 20,000 sales goods in April 2021. It is relevant for next year. Next year, but advance received during the accounting period, it has already recorded as revenue. It is not correct. It should be considered as a liability. But it is considered as revenue. It means it is included equity. Therefore, deduct 20,000 under equity. And it should be considered as a liability. Sales advance is a liability. Our accounting period end of the year 31st March 21. But advance received 20,000 for sales month of April 2021. Next year income received during the accounting period, that value should be considered as liability. Income received in advance is liability. But it has already considered as revenue. Therefore, it is included equity. Therefore, now deduct. And it should be considered as a liability. Next one. The electricity bill for the month of March 2021. Amount in 5,000 has been omitted from the records. Electricity expense for the month of March omitted from the records. Paid or not, we have to consider as expense. Therefore, electricity expense value equal 5,000. If it for equity decrease, but it has not paid. Therefore, accrual electricity liability also increase. Think what our accounting period 31st March 2021. Electricity bill for the month of March 2021 amounting 5,000 had been omitted from the records. And sales invoice 10,000 has been recorded twice in the sales journal. Sales journal is a prime in the books. Therefore, double entry also recorded twice. Normally, debtor controlled account debit sales account credit, but it has recorded twice. Therefore, now debtor controlled account credit, it means asset decrease, and sales account debit, it means equity also decrease. Recorded twice in the sales journal. Sales journal is a prime entry books. Therefore, double entry also recorded twice. For correction, one time should be removed. Therefore, debtors account credit, sales account debit. Sales decrease, equity decrease, and debtor decrease, asset decrease. Therefore, correct debtor value equal 990,000. And correct liability equal 325,000. As well as correct equity equal 665,000. Correct equity equals 665,000. They ask, what is amount of total assets and liability? Total assets and total liability, they ask. Therefore, question number 8, answer 1. Think about account in equation lesson. Account in equation together with error correction. Error correction, they ask in the account in equation. Error correction, they ask account in equation. I take the answers. Question number 9 and 10. Question number 9 and 10, 11 for property, plant and equipment. 9 and 10, 11 for property, plant and equipment. Use the following information, answer the question number 9 and 10. Think about relevant for property, plant, and equipment. There are two questions relevant for property, plant, equipment. Use the following information to answer the question number 9 and 10. Machine with cost value 42,000 and accumulated depreciation 28,000 as at 31st March 20. Think about cost and accumulated depreciation is given. Was exchanged with similar machine by an entity on the same day. Think exchange date also given. 31st March 2020, same day. Exchange price of old machine was agreed to it carrying amounts. Exchange value equal carrying amounts. And it has given price of new machine 44,000 and difference was paid in cash. Exchange. Think about cost value of new machine. Existing machine cost value equal 44,000. Cost value 44,000 and accumulated depreciation equal 28,000. Therefore, it carrying amount equal net book value equal cost minus accumulated depreciation. This is the carrying amounts of old machine. Carrying amount means net book value. Therefore, this is the net book value. Net book value of old machine. It is given net book value of old. Net book value equal cost minus accumulated depreciation just given 14,000. But we are going to purchase new machine 44,000. New machine it cost value equal 44,000. But it has given exchange price of old machine was agreed to it carrying amounts. Carrying amount equal exchange value. Therefore, exchange value also equal exchange value also equal carrying amounts. Carrying amount means 14,000. Napi parana machine ekak deela aluth ekak ganna yanne balanna. This is the carrying amount of old machine. Etara ekak api denne carrying amount ekatama. We are going to purchase new machine 44,000. Habai api gawa thiyena parana machine ekak denne carrying amount ekata. but exchange for vehicle carrying amounts. Therefore, there is no profit and loss. Carrying amount ekata manan denne profit ekak loss ekak naha. Carrying amount ekata wada wedi ganakata dunnot thamai profit ekak enne. Carrying amount ekata wada net book kalekata wada adu ganakata dunnot thamai loss ekak enne. But it has given exchange price of old machine was agreed it carrying amounts. Therefore, exchange value and carrying amount both are equal. Therefore, there is no profit and loss. But we are going to purchase new machine. New machine, it cost value equal 44,000. New machine cost value equal 44,000. Same balance part paid in cash. Therefore, difference value paid in cash. The difference was paid in cash. Think how much paid in cash. Therefore, paid in cash for purchase new machine. Paid in cash for purchase new machine. Paid in cash for purchase new machine. Think about new machine cost value equal 44,000 and exchange value equal 14,000. Therefore, paid in cash 30,000. Those are the information given by the examiner. Now see the requirements. What is the following estimate is true in relation to this exchange? First one they ask. They ask which of the following statement true? It has given relevant for profit and loss. Think about exchange value equal carrying amounts. Profit ekak hari loss ekak hari wenne enne carrying amount ekata wada exchange value ekak wenas unoth. Exchange value ekak wedi unoth profit ekak enawa. Exchange value ekak adu unoth loss ekak enawa. But in this example it has given exchange value equal carrying amounts. Therefore there is no profit and loss. No gain or loss would result. Therefore answer is 5. There is no exchange profit and loss. Reason carrying amount of old machine equal exchange value. Next one they ask, what is the net increase in carrying amounts of machine of the entity due to this exchange? Net increase in assets they ask. Net increase in carrying amount of this machine of due to this exchange. Think about carrying amount equal cost minus accumulated depreciation. Think about existing machine carrying amount equal 14,000 and new machine cost value equal 44,000. It has not given accumulated depreciation. Apengana parana machine ekak deela aluth machine ekak gatte nisa carrying amount ekata vena effect ekak net increase. If it has not exchanged carrying amount equal 14,000. If it has exchanged carrying amount equal 44,000. Reason it has not given accumulated depreciation. Exchange end of the year. Therefore, carrying amount increased by difference value. As a result of this transaction, they ask carrying amount increased by how much? What is the net increase in carrying amounts? What is the net increase in carrying amounts due to this exchange? And think what? If it has not exchanged carrying amount equal 44,000, if it has exchanged cost per week equal 44,000 new machine, but it accumulated depreciation is not given. Therefore, it carrying amount equal 44,000. Therefore, what is the net increase? If it has exchanged carrying amount equal 44,000, if it has not exchanged carrying amount equal 14,000. Therefore, net increase in carrying amount equal 30,000. Therefore, this is the answer. Net increase in carrying amounts equal 30,000. Parana machine ekak deela aluth machine ekak gatta. Then api gawa thiyena aluth machine ekak eka accumulated depreciation naha. Therefore it carrying amount equal to 44,000. But if it has not exchanged old machine available, it carrying amount equal 14,000. Therefore what is the net increase in carrying amounts? Therefore net increase in carrying amount equal 30,000. Therefore, question number 10, answer 3. Question number 10, answer 3. Next one. क्वेश्चन नंबर 11 रिलेवेंट फॉर पार्टनरशिप्स. Relevant for goodwill adjustment. He has given Anu, Danu, and Madhu work career in a partnership business and follow and share in profit and loss equally. Profit sharing ratio is given equally. Anu retired from the partnerships business on 31st March 2021, and goodwill of the business was adjusted in the capital accounts. It has given Danu and Madhu decided to continue the business and given capital account balance before adjusting goodwill as well as after adjusting goodwill. Think about, there are three partners available, Anu, Danu and Madhu. Retirement Anu and given before adjusting goodwill as well as after adjusting goodwill. Capital account balance it has given. That's what is the total goodwill. Very important this example. There are three partners available. Anu, Danu and Madhu. Think about Anu also available. Anu, Danu and Madhu. And given profit share in ratio 1:1:1. Equally. Profit share in ratio it has given equally. Profit share in ratio it has given profit share in ratio 1:1:1. There are three partners. Profit share in ratio 1:1:1. Three partners. But given before adjusting goodwill as well as after adjusting goodwill, capital account balance. Think what, as a result of goodwill adjustment, think what is effect for capital account balance. As a result of goodwill adjustment, think what is effect for capital account balance. Danu capital account balance decreased by 40,000. Capital account balance of Danu decreased by 40,000. And Madhu capital account balance decreased by 10,000. As a result of goodwill adjustment, think what is effect for capital account balance. Anne capital account ke balance ka adu vechi gana tamai retire vechi kana yanne. Therefore, that it is called share of goodwill. As a result of goodwill adjustment, capital account balance decreased by 50,000. That is the share of goodwill of Anu. Goodwill adjust karana kota. Anith partners lagging aduena gana tamai retire venekkinada yan. Therefore, decrease by 50,000. It is equal share of goodwill of Anu. Again, 1 kiyane ke answer ekama 50,000. 150,000. Think about second one. Then next one. 1:1:1. Therefore, share of goodwill equal 50,000. Share of goodwill of Anu. Share of goodwill of Anu. Share of goodwill of Anu. Share of goodwill of Anu equal 50,000. 40,000 plus 10,000. Therefore, share of goodwill of Anu equal 50,000. It is equal 1. Profit share and ratio, it has given 1:1:1. Therefore, goodwill of the business equal goodwill of the partnerships. Goodwill of the partnership equal 50,000 into 3. Total profit share equal 3. Share of profit equal 1. Therefore, share of goodwill equal 50,000. Therefore, total goodwill equal 150,000. Goodwill adjust karana kota. Capital ke balance ka adu venne retire venne kinada yana gana. It is called share of goodwill. Therefore, share of goodwill of retire partner equal 50,000. Profit share in ratio equal 1:1:1. Therefore, total goodwill equal 150,000. This example very, very important. think how to calculate goodwill of the partnerships. As let's think about share of goodwill also. Question number 11, answer 5. Next one, question number 12, relevant for ratio analysis. Question number 12, relevant for ratio analysis. Business paid rupees 400,000 as rent, but those value relevant for next financial year. What is the impact of current ratio and quick ratio? That is a prepaid rent, but paid in cash. Salary will give a rent taker, a may out rather than a thing. That is a prepaid rent. They ask what is effect for current ratio and quick ratio. Think how to calculate current ratio and quick ratio. Current ratio equal current assets divided by current liability. Current assets divided by current liability current assets divided by current liability equal current ratio and quick ratio equal quick assets right quick asset it has given quick asset divided by quick asset divided by current liability, that's a quick ratio. Like this example, normally they ask in the paper. Right, this is the ratio, current ratio and quick ratio. Now think what is effect? Think what is effect? Onama ratio ekka yata gana wedi unoth answer ekak adu wenawa. Ude ekka wedi unoth answer ekak wedi wenawa. Onama ratio ekka. Now think what business paid 400,000 rent expense. Therefore, rent expense paid in cash. But those value relevant for next financial year. It is called prepaid rent. Think what is it? Paid in cash, therefore, cash decrease. Cash decrease. Paid in cash, therefore, cash decrease. As well as prepaid rent, that value cannot be considered as expense. Therefore, prepaid rent asset, again, current asset increase. Current assets decrease and current asset increase. Same value 400,000. Therefore, net effect for current assets, zero. Therefore, current ratio not change. Paid in cash, therefore cash decrease 400,000. Current assets decrease. As well as it is relevant for next financial year, those are called prepaid expense. Therefore, prepaid expense also part of current assets. Again, current asset increase. That value cannot be considered as expense. Reason it is relevant for next financial year. Therefore, there's effect for current ratio zero, not change. But think about quick asset ratio. Quick asset not includes inventory and prepaid expense. Quick asset not include inventory and prepaid expense. Think about cash paid 400,000 as a prepaid rent. Effect for cash decrease. Therefore, quick asset decrease. And prepaid expense increase. But prepaid expense is not part of quick asset. Therefore, prepaid expense not effect for quick asset. Paid in cash, therefore quick asset decrease. Uday kadu not ratio kadu yano. Therefore ratio also decrease. Therefore quick asset ratio decrease. Thing very important. Prepaid rent is not part of quick assets. Therefore quick asset ratio decrease, but current ratio not change. Therefore answer is 5. क्वेश्चन नंबर 12 आंसर 5 थिंग हाउ टू कैलकुलेट पेड इन कैश एज ए प्रीपेड रेंट या फॉर करंट एसेट इंक्रीज करंट एसेट डिक्रीज नेट इफेक्ट फॉर करंट एसेट जीरो या फॉर करंट रेशियो नॉट चेंज बट क्विक एसेट रेशियो प्रीपेड रेंट इज नॉट इंक्लूडेड क्विक एसेट्स ओनली कैश इफेक्ट इफेक्ट therefore question number 12 answer 5 think about 13 question number 13 relevant for project evaluation this example very very important think how to calculate net present value assume other factor remain unchanged state whether each of following item මේ පාට් එක අනිවාර්යෙන් අල්ල ගන්න try කරන්න අමාරුයි. එනවා අනිවාර්යෙන් paper එකේ. Question number 13 assume other factor remain unchanged state whether each of following item increase or decrease and net present value of an investment project increase or decrease they ask. Increase expected cash inflow cash inflow එක වැඩි වුණොත් මොකද වෙන්න බලන්න net present value එකට think what is paid for net present value initial investment change residual value change then operating income increase operating expense increase like that and increase expected cash inflow එක වැඩි වුණොත් cash flow එක වැඩි වෙනවා therefore effect for net present value increase effect for net present value increase next one an increase in discounting rate ekak wedi unoth discount factor ekak adu wenawa ekena 10% kiyana ekak 20% unoth ema present value ekak adu wenawa therefore interest rate increase and increase discount rate එක වැඩි වුණොත් එම ෆැක්ට් එක අඩු වෙනවා therefore it is paid for net present value decrease this one very important එකනේ 0.9 තැනකට 0.8 වෙනවා discount rate එක වැඩි වෙනකොට increase in discounting rate think how to calculate present value and decrease initial investment initial investment කියන්නේ minus value එකක්. ඒතර minus එක අඩු වුණොත් එම net present value increase වෙනවා. This part very important. මේක එකපාර තේරෙන්නේ නැහැ. ටික ටික හිතන්න. එනවා paper එක අනිවාර්යෙන්. And decrease residual value. Residual value last year cash inflow. නම් cash inflow එකක් අඩු වුණොත් cash flow එක අඩු වෙනවා. इतर नेट पर्सन वैल्यू का अड़ गया therefore क्वेश्चन नंबर 13 वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट मेक एक पार तेरुंगा नमारुई टिकट के हितान इनवा अनिवार्य पेपर के थिंक अबाउट एग्जांपल रिलेवेंट फॉर प्रोजेक्ट इवैल्यूएशन अरे प्रोजेक्ट इवैल्यूएशन गान हदने गान आते हितान थिंक व्हाट इज पेड फॉर नेट पर्सन वैल्यू इफ इनिशियल इन्वेस्टमेंट चेंज operating income change operating expense change residual value change working capital change and discounting rate එක වැඩි වෙනකොට discount factor එක අඩු වෙනවා factor එක කියන්නේ 10 point එක දෙන්නේ අන්න ඒක discount rate කියන්නේ 10% 20% කියන එක discounting rate එක වැඩි වෙනකොට factor එක අඩු වෙනවා therefore it is paid for present value that question number 14 there's what is the impact of right issue of shares on the value of assets and equity of the company if all rights have been exercised by the existing shareholders think about right issue Company issues shares to the existing shareholders for cash. That is right issue. Company salable share issue karna to the existing shareholders. It is effect for cash increase as well as ordinary share increase. Therefore, cash increase, asset increase, and ordinary share increase. Therefore, equity also increase. Therefore, question number 14, answer 1. As a result of right issue. Right issue means company issues shares to the existing shareholders for cash. Therefore, effect for cash increase as well as ordinary share increase. Therefore, asset increase as well as equity increase. Next one. 15. What is the impact of reserve capitalization of asset and equity? Think about reserve capitalization. Bonus issue. Ordinary share increase, reserves decrease. It may be return on in, it may be general reserves. Not prepared for asset. Therefore, asset net impact zero, not change. And equity, ordinary share increase, reserves decrease. Equity increase, equity decrease, net effect for equity also zero. Therefore, answer is 5, not change. Both asset and equity not change. Net impact not change. Therefore, what they asked, what is the impact of reserve capitalization on value of asset and equity? Therefore, it is not effect for cash, not effect for assets. But ordinary share increase and reserves decrease. Therefore, net effect for equity also zero. Ordinary shares and reserves both are equal. Question number 16. Relevant for projective valuation. Question number 16, relevant for projective valuation. Last lesson. Think how to calculate cash flow initial as well as annual. Company is considering to replace its old machine used in production with new machine. And given useful lifetime of old machine as well as new machine 4 years. Following information is also given. And description old machine and new machine. Purchase price of new machine. Initially we have incurred. And current disposal value of old machine, selling price of old machine, year zero cash inflow. If old new machine was purchased, old machine could be sold. And given expected residual value after 4 years new machine, last year cash inflow. And last part very important, annual operating cost. Think about new machine 5,000, but old machine 8,000. By purchasing new machine, operating cost can be reduced. Operating cost ekak apita adu karaganna puluwan. That is the benefits. Therefore, decrease in operating expense, that is a cash inflow. Decrease in operating expense, that is a cash inflow. That's initial cash flow as less cash flow year 4. Prepare the cash flow. There are 4 years. Year 0 to 4 years. And think about description also. Therefore, year 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. First one, think about purchase price of new machine. Purchase price of new machine, cash inflow. Purchase price of new machine, cash inflow. So purchase price of new machine, cash outflow, year 0. Aluth machine ganne anagana, effect for cash decrease. Therefore, first one it has given purchase price. You have to consider only new machine, not existing machine. It has already purchased. අපි දැන් යන්නේ අලුත් මැෂින් එක ගන්නවද නැද්ද කියලා ඩිසයිඩ් කරන්න මේ යන්නේ. When we are going to decide to purchase new machine, initially we have to incur 15,000. Therefore, purchase price of new machine. Effect for cash decrease year zero within brackets 15,000. Only new machine, and it is given current disposal value of old machine, selling price of old machine 5,000 year zero cash inflow. අලුත් එක ගත්තොත් පරණ එක විකුණනවා සල්ලි අපිට එනවා. And residual value, it has given expected residual value of new machine 3,000. Therefore, residual value of new machine last year after 4 years. Residual value of new machine last year cash inflow 3,000. Next one, by purchasing new machine, operating cost can be served. Therefore, decrease in operating expense. Decrease in operating cost. It has given excluding depreciation. Cost එක අඩු කරගන්න පුළුවන් කියන එකත් වාසියක් අපි. Therefore, decrease operating expense. Think what operating cost can be reduced by 3,000 by purchasing new machine. Each year cash inflow. एक्सपेंस एक आडवी ना क्या ने साल लिया पे देना होगा कि ईच दोस्त अध इनफॉरमेशन गिवन बाय द एक्सामिनर दैट्स इनिशियल नेट कैश फ्लो देयरफॉर थिंक व्हाट इनिशियल मीन ईयर जीरो दैट्स इनिशियल नेट कैश फ्लो वैल्यू इक्वल 10,000 कैश आउटफ्लो. As well as last year, there's cash inflow. Last year cash inflow equals 6 million. Therefore, answer is initial net cash outflow equal 10 million, and cash inflow in year 4 equals 6 million. Therefore, question number 16, answer 1. Relevant for project evaluation. Very important thing: how to calculate cash flow. After that thing, how to calculate payback period. As well as net present value. Next one, question number 17. Relevant for EPF adjustment. Think what would be the answer? Question number 17, very important. Account in equation. Net salary 3.6 million was paid by the firm for the month end 31st March 20. The contribution of employee and employer for EPF 10% and 15%. Think about contribution of employee 10% and employer 15%. And these have not been paid for March 2020, and given EPF contribution is only deduction made from the employee salary. Effect of this transaction is shown in the accounting equation. Think what EPF adjustment it has given accounting equation. Net salary equal 3,600. Think what contribution of employee equal 10%. If gross salary 100, 10% deducted. Therefore, net salary equal 90. If gross salary 100, therefore, by using those information from the beginning, try to calculate gross salary. Therefore, gross salary equal net salary is given 3.6 million. employee contribution deducted already. If gross salary 100, contribution of employee equal 10%, therefore net salary equal 90. Therefore this one divided by 90 into 100 can be calculated gross salary. Therefore gross salary equal 4 million. Gross salary equal 4 million. Given net salary, then based on gross salary, try to calculate EPF contribution of employer and employee. Therefore, EPF contribution of employer. EPF contribution of employer based on gross salary. Contribution of employer equal 15%. Another expense, therefore value equal 600,000. And try to calculate EPF contribution of employee also. EPF employee gross salary equal 4 million. Think what value should be calculated based on gross salary and 10%. Gross salary in 10%. Therefore, here value equal 400,000. Now think how to record in the accounting equation. Think what double entry also. Net salary should be recorded. Then EPF and ETF contribution of employee and employer. Think about accounting equation. Assets equal liability plus equity. First one, think about net salary paid in cash. What is double entry? Cash account credit, salary account debit. Cash account credit, therefore cash decrease, asset decrease 3.6 million. Salary account debit, salaries expense, expense increase, therefore equity decrease. Expense increase, therefore equity decrease 3.6 million. Then contribution of employee, also part of salary. Think about 400,000. Salary account debit, EPF payable account credit, double entry. EPF contribution of employee, think about part of salary. Salary account debit, EPF payable account credit, salary account debit. Therefore, expense increase, equity decrease 400,000. And EPF payable account credit, liability increase 400,000. Salary account debit, EPF payable account credit. Next one, EPF contribution of employer. EPF contribution of employer, another expense. It is not part of salary. Therefore, EPF contribution of employer, EPF expense account debit, EPF payable account credit. EPF expense account debit, therefore expense increase, therefore equity decrease. Expense ek wedi wenna hinda equity kaduwa. And EPF payable account credit, liability increase. Liability increase, therefore asset decrease 3.6 million. And liability increase 1 million. As well as equity decrease 4.6 million. Think equity decrease 4.6 million. Liability increase 1 million. Asset decrease 3.6 million. Therefore, answer asset decrease 3.6 million. Liability increase 1 million. As well as equity decrease 4.6 million. Very important. EPF adjustment, they ask with accounting equation. You have to know how to record each and every transaction by using accounting equation also. Next one. Question number 18, relevant for property and equipment disposal part. property, plant, and equipment, they are definite in the paper. And following information relevant for motor vehicle owned by the business. And given motor vehicle cost value opening balance, it is given 1st April 2020. Opening balance. And accumulated depreciation also given opening balance. Think about date, very important. This is a part of financial accounts. And given proceed from sales of motor vehicle on 1st October 2020. This is the disposal date. And disposal value is given 9.2 million. But within brackets it has given purchase on 1st April 2018 at cost value 20,000. This is the cost value of disposal assets. As well as it has given purchase of new vehicle on 1st January 2021. New asset also purchased during the current period. Think about opening balance, cost value, and accumulated depreciation. Disposal asset cost value. Purchase date and disposal date is given. Then can be recognized accumulated depreciation. Disposal value also given. Profit and loss can be calculated. And new asset also purchased, it has given date and value. And given depreciation rate 20%, straight line methods, they ask, what is the depreciation for the vehicle and loss of sales of motor vehicle during the year? Disposal loss, they ask, prepare the disposal accounts. Disposal profit and loss can be calculated by using disposal accounts. Prepare the T account for that. Disposal accounts. Disposal profit and loss can be calculated by preparing disposal accounts. T accounts. Therefore, this is a disposal accounts. Take the cost value of disposal assets. Disposal, we are going to calculate profit and loss. Disposal accounts. Think cost value of disposal asset, it has given 20,000. Disposal account should be recorded cost value, disposal value, as well as accumulated depreciation. After that, profit and loss can be calculated. And prepare the disposal accounts, take the given information. Cost value of disposal asset, it has given 20 million. Therefore, motor vehicle account credit, disposal account debit. Cost value of disposal asset should be recorded debit side as a motor vehicle. Motor vehicle account credit, disposal account debit. Value equal 20,000 cost value. Value equal 20,000. Motor vehicle account credit, disposal account debit. Cost value and given disposal value also 9,200. Cash account debit, disposal account credit. Therefore, 9,200 as a cash account debit, disposal account credit 9,200. Then try to calculate accumulated depreciation also of disposal assets. It has given disposal date and purchase date. Can be recognized how many years used. And given cost value also. Annual percentage also given. Then calculate accumulated depreciation. Accumulated depreciation. Accumulated depreciation of disposal assets. Accumulated depreciation of disposal asset can be calculated. Think cost value equal 20,000, values in 1,000. Annual rate is given 20%. Now try to recognize how many years used from purchase date to disposal date. given purchase date 1st April 2018, but disposal date 1st October 2020. From purchase date to disposal date, it has available 2 years and 6 months. Therefore, into 2 years and 6/2. Think how to calculate accumulated depreciation. 2 years and 6/12. Therefore, accumulated depreciation of disposal is equal 10,000. Double entry, accumulated depreciation account debit, disposal account credit. Therefore, disposal account credit as accumulated depreciation. Value equal 10,000. Accumulated depreciation account debit, disposal account credit. Now, by closing disposal accounts, can be calculated disposal profit and loss. Take total amounts, increase side. Disposal profit and loss can be calculated. Take total amount of increase side. Now, think about increase side, debit side. Therefore, take debit side total amounts. Debit side total amount equal to 8,000. And take that value credit side. Take that value credit side. Then difference value loss. Therefore, here difference value equal. Think about difference value equal 8,000. That is disposal loss. Therefore, disposal loss equal. Disposal loss equal 800. Therefore, this is where you have to calculate disposal profit and loss by preparing disposal accounts. Definitely, they are in the paper. All the business available non-current assets. You have to know how to record if those are disposed. Then think how to calculate annual depreciation. Try to recognize how many months available each asset during the accounting period. Disposal assets. Balance part as well as purchase asset also. Right, try to calculate annual depreciation. Annual depreciation. Calculation of annual depreciation. Annual depreciation. Disposal asset cost value equal to 20,000. Calculate from the beginning disposal asset. Disposal asset cost value equal to 8,000 and it has given depreciation rate 20%, but disposal date is given 1st October 2020. Therefore, disposal asset available during the accounting period only 6 month period. Our accounting period end of the year 31st March 21. It means beginning of the year 1st April 2020. Therefore, from 1st April 20 to disposal date, think what we reduce the concepts. Our accounting period end of the year 31st March 21. It means beginning of the year 1st April 2020. Therefore, our accounting period end of the year 31st March 21, disposal asset available up to disposal date only 6 month period. Therefore, if asset used based on matching concepts, annual depreciation should be calculated. Therefore, annual depreciation 6/12. Take down annual depreciation. Disposal asset available only 6 month period. Disposal asset available only 6 month period. Therefore, disposal asset annual depreciation equal 2000. And think about balance part. Opening balance equal 60,000, but disposal asset cost value equal 20,000. It means balance part equal 40,000. Therefore, balance part. Think opening balance equal 60,000, and disposal asset cost value equal 20,000. Therefore, balance part it cost value equal 40,000. This is the cost value balance part. Based on that value, also you have to calculate 20%. it has available entire year. Therefore, balance part, not disposal, it has available entire year. Therefore, based on that value, you have to calculate 20% value equal 8,000. As well as new asset also purchased, it has given. Purchase date it has given 1st January 2021. Think it has available how many months? Our accounting period end of the year 31st March 21. Therefore, disposal is available January, February, March. New assets. New motor vehicle also available. New motor vehicle. It cost per vehicle 36,000. Think if it has used, should be calculate depreciation. Annual rate is given 20%, but it has not available entire year. It has available January, February, and March, only 3 month period. Therefore, 3/2. Take it depreciation. Therefore, it depreciation equal 1,800. Now take the total value. Think how to calculate annual depreciation. Take total value equal 11,800. This is the way you have to calculate annual depreciation based on matching concepts. Try to recognize how many months available each asset. Therefore, annual depreciation equal 11,800,000. And disposal loss equal ₹800,000. Therefore, the answer. Depreciation as well as disposal loss. Therefore, answer is 5. This is answer. Answer is 5. Disposal adjustment very important. Disposal adjustment. Therefore, question number 18, answer 5. Think how to calculate disposal profit and loss as well as how to calculate annual depreciation. You have to apply matching concepts. Income should be matched with its corresponding expenses. Therefore, question number 18, answer 5. Next one, question number 19. Relevant for CVP analysis. Question number 19, relevant for CVP analysis. It has given then both selling price and it has given both selling price per unit and variable cost per unit increased by 10%. Fixed cost remain unchanged. There's effect of contribution per unit and contribution to sales ratio, 10%. Think how to calculate contribution per units as well as contribution to sales ratio. Contribution per unit equal, selling price per unit minus variable cost per unit. This is the way you have to calculate contribution per units. And contribution to sales ratio, how to calculate? It is called CS ratio. CS ratio equal contribution per unit divided by selling price. Contribution per unit divided by selling price. Into 100. Think how to calculate CS ratio. Therefore, this is the way you have to calculate contribution to sales ratio. Contribution per unit divided by selling price into 100. Now, think it has given selling price and variable cost decreased by 10%. That's what is prepared for contribution to sales ratio and contribution per units. Now assume if selling price, think what selling price equal assumptions. Pramana meva hitting apita hadanna ba me vidire hadanna assume karala ganna selling price ekak assume selling price api hitama selling price ekak 50,000 and variable cost think about 30,000 variable cost assume 30,000 in this situation try to calculate then me tatte yadde baramu contribution per units ඊට පස්සේ බලමු අඩු වුණොත් 10% think about selling price minus variable cost therefore in this situation selling price 50,000 and minus variable cost selling price minus variable cost equal contribution per units selling price minus variable cost equal contribution per units therefore contribution per unit equal 20,000 contribution per unit equal 20,000 and try to calculate CS ratio CS ratio equal contribution per unit divide by selling price into 100 in this situation try to calculate contribution per unit equal 20,000 and selling price equal 50,000 selling price equal 50,000 and into 100 take the answer this is a CS ratio therefore assume value then take the answers therefore 100 therefore answer equal here answer equal 40% in this situation CS ratio equal 40% as well as contribution per unit equal 20,000 now think about selling price and variable cost decreased by 10% it has given both selling price and variable cost per unit increase both selling price and variable cost per unit increase by 10% now try to calculate new selling price and new variable cost after increase 10% new selling price as well as new variable cost new selling price it has given 50,000 selling price 50,000 increase by 10% equal 5,000 therefore new selling price also equal 55,000 new selling price equal 55,000 think about increase by 10% try to calculate new selling price as well as new variable cost per unit equal 30,000 it has also increased by 10% therefore 10% means 3,000 therefore think about new variable cost equal 33,000. Now try to calculate in this situation. In this situation, try to calculate new contribution per units as well as new contribution per units as well as try to calculate new CS ratio after increase selling price and variable cost. Then try to calculate contribution per units now. Contribution per units equal selling price minus variable cost therefore selling price equal now 55,000 minus variable cost equal 33,000 selling price minus variable cost can be calculate contribution per units therefore new contribution per unit equal 22,000 think what is prepared for contribution per units and try to calculate CS ratio CS ratio equal contribution per unit divided by selling price. Contribution per unit equal 22,000 and selling price equal 55,000 into 100. Into 100. Think what is if selling price and variable cost increase by 10%. This is a way you have to take answer. This is a way you have to take answer. Right, take the CS ratio and contribution per units. Calculator can be used. Take the answer. 22,000 divided by 55,000 into 100. therefore same value. Think what percentage is equal 40%. But CS ratio is not changed. Very important. Think if selling price and variable cost increase by 10%, they ask what is paid for contribution per unit. Think contribution per unit increase by 2000, but CS ratio same value. Very very important. On a heating other than main other than video bala. Assume color value got done. This is a CS ratio. Selling price and variable cost increased by 10%. Therefore, assume selling price and variable cost. In this situation, calculate contribution per unit and CS ratio. After increase by 10%, take new selling price and new variable cost. Then calculate new contribution as well as new CS ratio. Think what would be the answer. Contribution per unit increase, but CS ratio not change. Therefore, question number 19, answer 1. Question number 19, answer 1. Contribution per unit increase, but CS ratio is not changed. Therefore, question number 19, answer 1. Very important this one. Make your answer ganna vidhi hitan. Then make any patati dan. If selling price and variable cost decrease by 10%. Decrease not mukha vene contribution kadu venama. By CS ratio Venus Venina. Percentage of Duno. Rupee Velivica Duno, maybe. That because the selling price and variable cost decreased by 5,000 kin. It could may answer in a win. It could may again assume Kalagana Velivica. It has a new selling price and variable cost should be calculated. Then think like this. Very important question number 19. Therefore, answer is first one. Next one, question number 20. Question number 20. Relevant for debtors and creditors reconciliation. Also very important part, debtors and creditors reconciliation. Use the following information. Ask the question number 20 and 21. Relevant for debtors and creditors reconciliation. Use the following information. Ask the question number 20 and 21. And given balance of debtor control accounts in the general ledger as at 31st March 20, 2.8 million. However, this balance is not agreed with total balance of extracted from debtor's ledger. Debtor's ledger mean debtor list. And following were revolved in subsequent investigation. Given reason for difference, they ask total debtor's balance extracted from debtor's ledger before correcting above errors. That is the debtor list balance. You have to prepare debtor's reconciliation. And correct balance of debtor control account, they ask 31st March 20. You have to prepare adjusted debtor control accounts. Therefore, prepare adjusted debtor control accounts as well as statement of debtors reconciliation. P accounts, adjusted debtor control accounts, as well as statement of debtors reconciliation. Prepare the adjusted debtor control accounts. Adjusted debtor control as well as statement of debtor reconciliation. Prepare the statement of debtor's reconciliation also. Statement of debtor's reconciliation. Statement of debtor's reconciliation. Therefore, this is the statement of debtors reconciliation. Statement of debtors reconciliation. based on adjusted data control account balance. There's data list balance also. Data's ledger balance mean data risk balance. Therefore, take from the beginning adjusted data control account balance. Adjusted data control accounts balance. This is adjusted data control account balance. Adjusted data control account balance. Then some information we have added, addition, and some information deduct. Space for that. Deduction and addition. Adjusted data control accounts. They ask data list balance. We are going to calculate data list balance. Data list balance. Data's ledger balance equal data list balance. Think about debtors and creditors reconciliation. They ask definitely in the paper. Lesson for double payment books and ledger. Right from the beginning, take the balances it has given from the beginning. Balances of data control account in the general ledger as at 31st March 20, it has given 2,800 values in 1,000. Data is asset, therefore that value should be input as a balance brought forward. Debit side in the adjusted data control accounts. Record values in 1,000. And given reason for difference, now think, if errors occur in the general ledger, control account should be adjusted. But if errors occur in the debtors ledger, should be included in the reconciliation. When some information included in the reconciliation, how to decide add or deduct? See the effect for closing balance. If effect for closing balance increase, those are should be added. If effect for closing balance decrease, those are should be deduct. That is a theory. When some information included in the reconciliation, you have to decide add or deduct. How to decide? See the effect for closing balance. If effect for closing balance increase, those are should be added. If effect for closing balance decrease, those are should be deduct. Right. First one thing we have to adjust. Issaroma yanne kohedath kiyala therum ganna. ඊට පස්සේ මොකද්ද කරන්න ඕන කියලා හිතන්න. එනවා අනිවාර්යෙන් paper එකේ. What is the theory? If errors occur in the general ledger, should be adjust control accounts. Think about first one, check 850,000 receipt from debtor during the month of March have been recorded only cash receipts journal and respective accounts in debtor's ledger recorded. However, this has not been posted to the general ledger. Think about has not been recorded general ledger. Effect for adjusted data control accounts. Checks receives 850,000. Effect for data decrease. But it has recorded cash receipt journal. But not recorded in the debtors control accounts. However, this has not been posted to the general ledger. Therefore, completely omitted. Completely not recorded in the general ledger. Double entry, cash control account debit, data control account credit. Recorded cash receipt journal, that is a prime invoice, but not recorded in the general ledger. General ledger, it has not recorded. Therefore, think about double entry, cash control account debit, data control account credit, 850 as a cash. As a cash control, first one, effect for adjusted data control accounts. It has not recorded, has not been posted to the general ledger. General ledger, available ledger accounts, cash control account and data control accounts. But it has recorded cash receipt journal as well as debtors ledger. It is not effect for reconciliation. Second one, credit sales 480,000. Credit sales 840,000 has been recorded in the sales journal as 408,000. Sales journalist primary books. However, this has been recorded in the debtor's ledger correctly. Debtor's ledger recorded correctly. Errors occur in the general ledger. It is also effect for adjusted debtor control accounts. Transaction credit sales 840,000, but it has recorded 408,000. Sales recorded under costed value. Then difference value equal 360,000. 360,000 under costed value recorded in the general ledger. This has been correctly recorded debtors ledger. Has been recorded sales journal is a prime end books. Sales journal is prime end books. But it has recorded correctly in the debtors ledger. Therefore, this one effect for general ledger. Debtor control accounts. Not effect for suspense. Therefore, credit sales double entry. Data control account debit, sales account credit. Therefore, 360,000 data control account debit as a sales. Next one. Bad debts written off amounting 450,000 has been correctly recorded in the general ledger. However, this has not been recorded respective debtors account in the debtors ledger. Thing errors occur in the debtors ledger. Bad debts was not recorded debtors ledger. Respective debtors accounts. Therefore, individual debtors balance. Individual debtors balance. Increased by. As a result of that, individual debtor balance increased by 450,000. Therefore, debtor list balance also increased. Debtor list balance also increased. Debtor list balance also debtor list balance also increased. Debtor list balance also increased by 450,000. Think debtor list balance increase. Bad debts written off amounting 450,000 has been correctly recorded in the general ledger. However, this has not been recorded in the respective debtors accounts. Bad debts can debtors adu enna balapanika. Record karlane. Therefore, effect for individual data balance increase. Therefore, data list balance increase. Therefore, closing balance increase. Effect for closing balance increase. Therefore, should be added. 450,000 should be added. Bad debts was not recorded individual data accounts. Bad debts was not recorded individual data accounts. Bad debts was not recorded individual debtors accounts. Bad debts was not recorded individual debtors account. Third one, effect for reconciliation. Think when some information included in the reconciliation, see the effect for closing balance. If effect for closing balance increase add, effect for closing balance decrease deduct. Think about fourth transaction. Balance of 320,000 has been omitted in extracting balance of debtors ledger. Think about errors occur in the debtors ledger. As a result, think what is effect for debtor list balance. Omitted in extracting debtors balance of debtors ledger. Debtor list ekak hadanakota omit vela. As a result, data list balance also effect for data list balance. Effect for data list balance also decreased by 320,000. effect for debtor list balance decreased by 320,000. Debtor list balance decreased, therefore closing balance decreased, therefore that value should be deducted. Think when some information included in the reconciliation, see the effect for closing balance. Think about debtor balance omitted when preparing debtor list. Therefore, effect for debtor list balance decrease, closing balance decrease, therefore should be deducted. Value be equal 320,000. Fourth transaction. Think what kind of information should be recorded debtor's reconciliation and adjusted debtor control accounts. Errors occur in the general ledger should be included adjusted debtor control accounts, but errors occur in the debtor's ledger should be included statement of reconciliation. Think how to decide add or deduct. Right, trust fund, try to calculate adjusted debtor control account balance. Those are very important. Take debit side total amounts. Take the debit side total amounts. 2,800 plus 360. Debit side total amount equal 3,160,000. Take that value credit side. Then difference value balance carry down. Therefore, deduct 850. Therefore, adjusted debtor control account balance equal. Adjusted debtor control account balance equal 2,310. Record values in 1,000 as a balance carry down. That value balance brought forward debit side. Value equal 2,310. This is adjusted debtor control account balance. And that value should be included in statement of reconciliation also. Record values in 1,000. Record values in 1,000. Debtors reconciliation also. Record values in 1,000. Therefore, adjusted debtor control account balance equal 2,310. Addition, add, deduction, deduct. Take the debtor list balance also. Therefore, addition total amount equal 450. Addition total amount equal 450. Therefore, take the answers. Therefore, here total amount equal 2,760,000 and deduction within brackets 320. Then can be calculated debtor list balance also. Therefore, debtor list balance equal 2,444. Recommend 20 days debtors ledger balance. Total debtors balance extracted from debtors ledger. Answer is 2,404. Therefore, question number 20 answer one. But question number 21, they ask correct balance of debtor control accounts equal 2,310. Therefore, question number 21 answers is part B. Think about debtors and debtors reconciliation. Lesson 2, lesson 4. Think debtors ledger, creditors ledger, general ledger. Debtor control account balance should be equal to debtor list balance. If those two balances are not equal, you have to know how to provide reason for difference. Debtors reconciliation. මේ ගණන් නැවත නැවත හදන්න. එතකොට හරියනවා. ගාන තනියෙන් හදන්න තේරෙන්න නම් බලාගෙන හදන්න ඉස්සරවම. ඒකම හිතන්න මොකද්ද වෙන්නේ කියලා. Think about theory part. Errors occur in the general ledger should be adjusted control accounts. And errors occur in the debtors ledger should be included reconciliation. When some information included in the reconciliation, think how to decide add or deduct. See the effect for closing balance. If effect for closing balance increased, those are should be added. If effect for closing balance decreased, those are should be deducted. Question number 22, relevant for not for profit making organization. Following information relevant for subscription of associated club for the year end 31st March 20. This one for the year 31st March 2021. This one 31st March 2021. And given subscription collected during the current period for last year, this year, next year. Think about received during the current period, cash account debit, subscription account credit. And given opening and closing balance. Opening and closing balance, it has given subscription receivable as well as subscription received in advance. They ask, what is amount of subscription income recognized for the year in 31st March 2021? Prepare the subscription accounts. P accounts, take the balances. Take the balances. Subscription received in advance. Subscription is income, but subscription received in advance is a liability. Subscription in arrears is an asset. Take the balances. This is a subscription accounts. This is a subscription accounts. Take the balance, subscription accounts. Subscription is income, but subscription received in advance is a liability. Subscription in arrears is an asset. It has given subscription receivable. That is a subscription in arrears. Asset opening balance brought forward. Opening balance equal 1800. Debit side as a balance brought forward. Balance brought forward. And closing balance as a balance carried down. Closing balance, balance carried down from credit side to debit side. Record from the beginning balances. And closing balance, it has given 2400. That value balance carried out. Value equal 2400. And given subscription received in advance also, liability, only opening balance it has given. Subscription received in advance, liability 900, credit side as a balance brought forward. Balance brought forward, credit side. And it has given here, think about subscription received amount during the accounting period. Our accounting period end of the year 31st March 2021. But during the accounting period, subscription received for 21 and 22 period. This is the subscription received in advance closing balance. Our accounting period end of the year 31st March 2021. But given subscription received amount included, received amount for next financial year, that is the value should be considered as a closing balance, subscription received in advance, 1300. It has not given here, therefore value equal 1300, that value balance carried out. Therefore think about subscription received in advance. Closing balance, it has not given, think how to calculate. Therefore that value balance carried down, liability from debit side to credit side. 1.3 million. And that value balance brought forward also same value. Balance brought forward same value. Value equal 1.3 million. 10th in subscription received amount during the current period. It has given subscription received in year 2020 and 21. For last year, for this year, for next year. All three value received during the current period. Take here total amounts. Total amounts received during the current period. Received during the current period, total value, this one, as well as this one, and this one, all three value received during the current period. Take the value total amount equal 1.6 million, 25 million 800, as well as 1 million 300,000. They have a total received amount equal 28 million 700,000. Cash account debit, subscription account credit. Therefore, total value received in cash during the accounting period. Double entry, cash account debit, subscription account credit. Therefore, subscription account credit as a cash, 28,700,000. It has not given subscription written off. Therefore, by closing subscription accounts, can be recognized subscription income. Take the credit side total amounts. their subscription income. Credit side total amount equals 32,000. Take that per debit side. Then deduct 1,800 as less 1,300. They have 28,900. As income, you have to consider 28,900 as income statement. Based on accrual concepts, this year's value should be considered as income, cash received or not, based on accrual concepts. Therefore, subscription income equal 28,900. Therefore, question number 22, answer third one. Question number 22, answer third one. Relevant for subscription, not for profit-making organization. Next one, question number 23. MCQ, very important. Question number 23, relevant for bank reconciliation. Think about unpresented, unrealized checks. Entity carry out all its cash transactions through the bank accounts. Monthly bank statement. So the credit balance. Bank ke credit balance ka kya na hoda balance ka. OD ka kya nevi. Have I cash book ke credit balance ka kya hoda? OD ka. It has given bank statement show the credit balance. Bank kua pating apay account ke liability ka. Eka hi credit pate balance ke diyen. Api asset ka kuna ata bank kua ta api liability ka. Therefore in the bank point of view we can see credit balance. On this date, check deposited but not realized. And check issue but not presented for payments. It has given value. There's balance of bank balance in the books of entity. There's adjusted cash control account balance. Prepare the statement of bank reconciliation. Prepare the statement of bank reconciliation. Prepare the statement of bank reconciliation. Unpresented and unrealized checks is given. Unpresented unrealized checks also given. Prepare the statement like this. This is a statement of bank reconciliation. There's bank balance in the books of entity. Entity means business point of view, they ask. Statement of bank reconciliation. Statement of bank reconciliation. Statement of bank reconciliation. From the beginning, adjusted cash control account balance. Adjusted cash control account balance. Then some information should be added and some information we have data. Adjusted cash control account balance should be used as a basis. It would be add current unpresented plus unpresented checks. Unpresented checks. Unpresented checks should be added. As well as minus unrealized checks. Minus unrealized. Unrealized checks should be deducted. Then answer is balance as per bank statement. Bank statement balance. Now it has given bank statement balance is given. Credit balance. In bank point of view, credit balance means not OD, positive value, 520,000. As well as given unpresented unrealized checks and given on this date, check deposited but not realized and issue but not presented for payments. Unrealized checks equal 600,000 deduct. and TLS is zero. And presented check sheet has given 250,000 plus. Unrealized deduct, unpresented plus. This one minus within bracket. It is enough one columns. It is enough one columns. Now think what they ask. Balance adjusted cash control account balance. They ask. Think what adjusted cash control account balance plus unpresented checks from that value data, unrealized checks equal balance statement balance. Then make up your other corona and if better than a pull would it have begun from balance statement balance? Aim out of the balance statement balance. I got to make a margin. There would have any unrealized checks. Yet then unpresented checks. May balance take a maru in a pulwa, but normally we have to prepare based on adjusted cash control accounts. They ask here balance now. Think what would be the answer? Adjusted cash control account balance plus this one equal here value. From that value deduct this one equal balance statement balance. Now it opposite side. Now 520,000 plus 600,000. Therefore here value equal 1,120,000. From that value deduct this one can be calculated adjusted cash control account balance. Therefore, adjusted cash control account balance equal 870,000. Think how to calculate adjusted cash control account balance. There's balance, bank balance in the books of entity. Books of entity mean adjusted cash control account balance. Therefore, question number 23, answer. One. Onna udata apita balance statement balance e ganna puluwan. Ehema gattot ehema me deka maaru wenno. Unpresented deduct karanna ona unrealized add karanna ona. But normally we have to prepare based on adjusted cash control accounts. Eka aniwary ne ona balance ekak udata ganna puluwan api. Right question number 23 answer 1. Then question number 24. Question number 24, 11 for error correction part. Question number 24. Following errors were revolved drafted. Revolved after preparing drafted financial statement of the business. Drafted mean there may be some errors. Cash received 53,000 from debtor has been recorded as a 35,000 debtor. Debtors accounts. You got cash receipt from debtor. Cash account debit, debtor control account credit has been recorded in the debtors accounts 35,000. Next one, credit sales 85,000 has been credited sales account 8,500. Sales under costs, sales accounts, and sales return 8,000. Has been debited to the sales accounts. Thus, due to these errors, the profit of the entity is understated by. Thus, profit of the entity is understated by. Prepare the working for that. Think about trans number one. Think what is it for profit. There's profit understated by how much? There's profit understated by how much? Think transaction number 1, 2, 3. Effect for profit only income and expense. There are three transactions it has given. First one, take the transaction. Think what is effect for profit? First one, cash received 53,000 from debtor has been recorded 35,000 in the debtor's accounts. It is not effect for income and expense. Therefore, it is not effect for profit. Net effect for profit zero. Reason, debtors and cash, if it, debtors and cash, those are not income, not expense. Those are it. आपको फर्स्ट वन नॉट टीपेड फॉर कभी, सेकंड वन क्रेडिट सेल्स 85,000 हैज बीन क्रेडिटेड टू द सेल्स अकाउंट्स 8,500 सेल्स अंडरकास्टर्स इनकम अंडरकास्टर्स देयरफॉर इट इज इफेक्ट फॉर प्रॉफिट इनकम एक अडू वेनरा एंड प्रॉफिट एक अडू वेला डिफरेंस वेरी इक्वल 76,500 देयरफॉर प्रॉफिट इफेक्ट फॉर प्रॉफिट डिक्रीज बाय 76,500 इफेक्ट फॉर प्रॉफिट 76,500 And sales return 8,000 has been debited to the sales accounts. Think about sales return should be debit sales return accounts, but it has already debited to the sales accounts. Effect for sales decrease. Normally sales return should be debit sales return accounts, but it has debited to the sales accounts. As a result, what is effect for sales decrease? But if it has debited to the sales return accounts, that value should be deducted from sales. Make then common at the sales filling adu karan eka. Have I debit pen on sales return account? Sales account take a debit pitch nisa, then at a month sales filling adu villa. Sales return account take a debit kalat, api antimate karan is sales filling adu karan eka. Therefore, it is also not debit for profit. Net impact for profit zero. Sales account debited, therefore already effect for sales decreased. If it has debited to the sales return account, that value should be deducted against sales accounts. Therefore, now net impact for net profit zero. Therefore, profit decreased by answer is 76,500. Therefore, profit decreased by 76,500. Answer is a fourth one. Question number 24, answer 4. Think about question number 25. Relevant for inventory. Question number 25, relevant for inventory. Item by item basis as well as group basis. Think about base and prudency concepts. This is application part of prudency concepts. Financial position as inventory. Lower value of cost and NRV should be included. When we are going to calculate lower amount of cost and NRV, two method can be applied. Item by item basis as well as group basis. It has given company has to provide following information as at 31st March 21, as well as for three item of inventory. For three item of inventory and given cost value, expected selling price, as well as expected selling expense. Expected selling price and expected selling expense relevant for net realizable value calculation, NRV calculation. Thus, according to item by item basis, what is the value of inventory as at 31st March 21? That first one, try to calculate net realizable value, NRV. Estimate selling price minus estimate selling expense. This one minus this one, take the answer. Think how to calculate net realizable value. It has not given. Definition, equation of net realizable value. Estimate selling price minus estimate selling expense as well as minus estimated further completion cost. Therefore, 880,000 minus 40,000 equal 840,000. 940,000 minus 10,000 equal 930,000. 830,000 minus 50,000 equal 708,000. Think about low amounts. Now you have to compare with cost value and NRV. This is the cost value. It should be compared with net realizable value. Then think about low amounts. Lower value based on prudency concepts. Lower value, think about A item by item. A cost value equal 850,000, but A NRV equal 840. Therefore, low amount equal 840. and B cost value equal 920, B NRV equal 930, therefore low amount equal 920, and C cost value equal 810, but NRV 708, therefore low amount equal 780. Think about item by item basis. Now take it total value. Take it total value. That is the value should be include financial person as inventory. That is value should be include financial position as inventory. Take the total value, low amount total value. Take the low amount it total value. That is value should be include financial position. Take the answers low amount total amounts. Lower value it total amounts. Equal 2,540,000. Therefore, this is the value should be included. Financial position as inventory based on prudency concepts. Therefore, here answer equal 2,540,000. Sometimes there's double entry. If there's double entry, think about cost value total amount also try to calculate. It should be included under cost of sales calculation based on matching concepts. Sometimes there's double entry. Therefore, cost value total amount equal 2,580,000. Then difference value is stock written off. If they ask double entry, inventory account debit. If they ask double entry, based on matching concepts under cost of sales calculations should be included cost value. Think about if they ask double entry, very important this one. Inventory account debit, low amounts 2,540,000. Inventory account debit. And stock written off account debit, difference value. Double entry. Stock written off difference value. Stock written off. Stock written off account debit. Stock written off account debit. Difference value equal. Think about this difference value. Cost value total amount equal 2,580. From that value deduct 2,540 low amounts. Therefore, difference value equal 40,000. Stock written off account debit and trade in account credit. Trade in account credit cost value based on matching concepts. Therefore, cost value equal 2,580,000. That is the value should be included under cost of sales calculation based on matching concepts. But based on prudence concepts, lower value of cost and NRV should be included financial position. Right. Second paper I will discuss after break. Class will be started 11 o'clock. Equal in class. Right, equal in. Cash flow statement I will discuss.